Hello, this is Benjamin from Maya HTT. In this video, I will show you how to perform test analysis correlation using frequency response functions, also known as FRF correlation, using Simcenter 3D FE model correlation tools. In this video, I will correlate the FRFs computed from an aluminum bike frame FE analysis with FRF extracted from a real test made on the same bike frame. I will start by showing you how to create the correlation solution. Then I will overlay test and analysis FRFs. And finally, I will display the frequency response assurance criterion as a color bar and as XY plots. To do the correlation, I need two sets of data. The test data, which is called the reference solution, and the FEA analysis data, which is called the work solution. To start the process, I need to import the test data. To do so, I create a test reference solution from the correlation toolbar, and I select two universal files. The first one contains the test geometry, and the second one contains the frequency response functions. The test reference solution now contains the accelerometer's location and orientation, as well as wireframe elements to represent the geometry. The test reference solution also points to an FRF set containing all the test FRFs. In this case, the measure type is acceleration over force. The responses are available at 27 output sensors for the excitation of nodes 4, 10, and 23, and from 0 to 500 Hz. Now that we know the available responses from the test reference solution, we can look at the FEA analysis called the work solution. The work solution is a Simcenter Nastran frequency response analysis with unit force excitation located at the same locations as the reference solution. Three orthogonal unit forces are applied at each excitation point to allow transformation to the local test coordinate system. The FRF correlation can now be created by selecting the reference solution first and the work solution afterward, and by specifying the node mapping tolerance. By creating the correlation, the sensor nodes from the reference solution are mapped to the closest nodes from the work solution. The node mapping can be verified in the correlation details view and in the graphic display. The correlation also creates a new FRF set list with the available responses from the work analysis. It's important that the measure type be the same as for the reference FRFs. Finally, the correlation creates pairs of FRFs between the reference and the work solution using the node map. The FRF correlation is now fully defined. I can start to display the available correlation results. I will use filters to show only the FRF pairs that contain input node 4 with responses that are in the X direction. I will now graph the test and the analysis FRFs as XY plots. If I select only one FRF pair, I can plot the FRF of the work solution only, the reference solution only, or an overlay of the work and the reference solutions. If I select multiple FRF pairs, an overlay is hard to understand because there are so many lines. To have a better global understanding, I can combine the response using an RMS average. Then there is only one curve for the average work FRFs and one curve for the average reference FRFs. Another useful metric comes from the frac. the frequency response assurance criterion. The FRAC evaluates how close the work and the reference FRFs are over their common frequency band. This comparison gives a factor between 0 and 1, with 0 meaning no correlation and 1 pointing to a perfect correlation. The FRAC is expressed as a function of a stretch factor, beta, which effectively shifts the frequency of the work solution. If there is a single peak in the FRAC plot at beta equals to 1, it means that all the modes correlate perfectly without any shift. A single peak at a beta greater than 1 means the FEM used in the work solution is softer than the test one. Similarly, a peak at beta below 1 means the work model is more rigid than the reference. In many cases, like in the one shown, the FRAC plot has more than one peak, which means some modes correlate well while others are stiffer or softer than the reference modes. It is possible to plot an overlay of the FRFs at a specific value of beta to see how the shifted work FRF correlates with the reference FRF. To do so, I turn on probing mode and I select one of the FRAC peaks. Then, I right-click and select Overlay FRFs. The FRF overlay plot created is shifted by beta stretch factor. In the first overlay with beta equal to 1, there is no frequency shift and the good correlation of the peaks at 85 Hz explain the high FRAC. If I do a second overlay at beta equals to 1.14, the shift of the work FRF is significant. The high FRAC at this beta comes from the good correlation of the peaks at 185 Hz. To look at the FRAC for many different FRFs at the same time, a convenient display is the color bar. With this graphic, the FRAC plot allows to evaluate visually if the work solution is generally stiffer or softer than the reference solution. It's a powerful tool to help to modify the work model to obtain a better FRF correlation. To conclude, in this video I've shown you the tools that are available to perform FRF correlation in Simcenter 3D FE model correlation product. Other key functionalities include pretest, model correlation, and model updating. These are demonstrated in other videos. Thank you for watching.